Hello, Keith Rucker here at VintageMachinery.org. Well, today I think I'm going to work on getting a couple of chucks cleaned up. These are from my LeBlond lathe. When I bought my LeBlond lathe, it came with a nice selection of chucks, but all of them had been in a shop that was somewhat open to the weather. There had been some sweating going on in there, and everything's got just a little coat of light rust on it. These look bad, but they're actually not very bad. In fact, I think that this chuck is a very new chuck. It doesn't look like it has had much use to it. There's very little wear down here on the serration on the jaws, which is a good indication. It still has a little sticker in here, which ironically we'll probably lose while we're cleaning it up. But anyway, what I'm going to do is we're going to take this chuck apart, and we're going to soak it in evaporust, get it all cleaned up, get it properly oiled up, and put it back together. I've got several chucks that we're going to be working on. This is the first one I'm going to do, which is my four jaw, simply because I need it, and I really just don't want to put it on the machine like this. I've got my three jaw that's on the lathe right now, which I kind of, you know, not the worst of it off, but it needs to be cleaned up right. I've also got a six jaw chuck that I want to do, as well as a face plate and a drive dog. So all those fit that lathe, and just want to get them all, you know, cleaned up and looking good as well. So on this one, this is a four jaw, so it has each individual jaw in here is independently adjustable. So there's four screws, and these are fairly easy to take apart because you just come in here and there's basically a worm in the back, as well as a worm gear that's in this machine into the independent jaws, and you just pull them out. So I don't have a proper chuck key. This one is a hex, and but I do have a hex I can put in my ratchet here. And so at some point in time, I'm probably going to have to make a key for this. But for right now, this well, I think it'll work. It's hitting right there. So let me go see if I can find a regular Allen wrench, because what's happening is back here on the back, as I get up right there, the diameter at the top is just too great. It's hitting it. So be right back. So I've got just a regular Allen wrench now. It doesn't have a very long handle on the top to give me much torque, but we can make it work. So that first one's out. We'll just pull these out. These don't have to go back in any certain one, so I'm not going to worry about that. Let's just go ahead and get all these jaws out, and then we'll go work on the rest of it here. So we pretty well have this one taken apart. I'm not going to take the actual screws out. It's going to be a little bit involved, and it really isn't going to matter for what I'm doing right now. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and take this and get her soaking and some evaporust to get this cleaned up. So I've just got a plastic wash tub here that this should fit down into. It's deforming a little bit, but it's in there. That's the main thing. Let me get my little jaws and put them down in there as well. We got them all in there, and what I'm using here, guys, so what I'm using is this product right here. It's called Evaporust, and it's basically just a liquid that you can soak stuff in for several hours. I usually let it go overnight, but usually a couple of hours is all you need. It's a pretty safe product. Water, you can dilute it with water or whatever. It doesn't really have any acids in it. But it does a really, really good job at removing rust. So I've actually got some. You can use this stuff over and over again, and I've got some here that's in a different tub that I've been using to clean up some drill bits. So I'm going to pour this in first. So you can use it. I had some before. I probably used it about 10 or 12 times before I really got all the good out of it, and eventually it just kind of quits working. There, I'm gonna almost have enough with this right here. I don't want to, there's some stuff in the bottom I don't want to get in there. Now, one thing you want to make sure is that you get it completely submerged. I've noticed that if something is not completely submerged with this, you kind of get a line right there where it meets the air or whatever. It kind of etches it a little bit. So we got some fresh product here, and I'm just going to pour enough in here to just get the top covered up good, and that should be plenty. And we're just going to go off and let this cook for a while. I like to just put something over the top of it just to keep it from evaporating too much. So it's about noon on a Saturday, so we'll come back later this evening and see if we can take them out. While my four jaw is over there cooking in the stew, I think I'm going to go ahead and pull this three jaw apart and have it ready to go in as soon as we take the other one out. Go ahead and get these parts de-rusted and cleaned up. We're just going to go ahead and disassemble this one. I'm going to start by taking these jaws off here. These will just screw on, so you can basically have a second set for doing inside gripping. These are all for, I guess these up here you can do outside gripping with. You can flip them around, whatever. But anyway, there's a second set of these, and I'm just going to zip them off real quick. So I say I am. Let's see if we can break those loose. Wow. Okay. Well, these jokers are really tight. I've been able to break them loose though like this. So I just got a regular 3/8 inch key or hex wrench, and I'm just tapping them with a hammer, and that seems to be breaking them loose. Now let's see if we can get them out much better. I'm going to take them now, and we're going to spin the scroll around, and we'll actually pull all three of these plugs out. We're going to take this chuck completely apart, clean the scroll, the whole nine yards, so I need to get them out of there. All right, these are all out now, and you can see the number stamped on right there. The scroll looks pretty clean, that's good. A lot of times you'll get junk and trash up inside the scroll here. Particularly when you use a lot of compressed air, it'll get it down in there. It's actually a good idea just periodically to pull these things apart and give them a good cleaning, re-grease them and all that, which is basically what we're doing now as part of this total cleanup on them. So let's flip this over. And there's three screws in the back, and this plate should raise up. There's a couple other screws in here. Probably have to go ahead and take those out too. So let's see if we can get these apart. Those are on there tight too, guys. So we're gonna have to tap them with the hammer like we did the other ones. Play in it, I don't like that. You know what, these may be metric. The front side is not metric, but I bet these are metric. Let me see if I can find a metric Allen wrench to pull those out with. All right, my suspicion was correct. It's 10 millimeter. Let's see if we can tap these and get them loose. When you put these back together, there's really no reason to have them as tight as they are right now. I suspect someone put these together with an impact wrench, a pneumatic impact wrench, and just really got them a lot tighter than they need to be. real nice and clean down inside those holes. I don't think this chuck has seen very much use. Don't think it's seen very much use at all. Let me get a screwdriver. There's three screws in here as well. And see if we can get this back plate off. At least those aren't in too tight. Those, I think, are set screws. I bet they're holding something in with this little key here. We may not have to take all those out to get this off, but I'm gonna take them all out anyway. So now the challenge is we got to get this back plate separated. This is a machine fit into a pretty tight tolerance. It's not probably not a press fit, but it's just a really tight fit. But there are two holes that are through here that are basically pushers to help push this, separate this apart. And I figured they were metric. As luck would have it, they're the same threads that came out of here, so we can use these same screws, or two of these same screws, and put in here. And we should be able to crank on these two and it'll just mechanically lift that apart. At least that's my plan. I did take a tap. I had a metric tap. What was that, a 12 millimeter 1.75 thread? And I just chased these to make sure that it was going to come apart. And you should be able to start to see this thing separating as we come up here. Yeah, it's coming up. I just do a little bit on one side and a little bit on the other. All right, something's not right. These are not coming apart. I mean, they started up real easy and then they got real tight on me, so I'm going to take a break here before I break something and see if we can figure out what's holding these things in. So give me a second to ponder this thing. So all right, guys, lesson here. So I realized something was binding up. It wasn't coming out like it was needed to. So I went around and started just trying to investigate anything I could. And I noticed that my key plugs here were bound up. They wouldn't do anything. So when I loosened it back up, took the pressure off, these need to come out. And to do that, I had to pull these little set screws out that were in here. And I couldn't get them out at first. So let me show you what I did. I got these little rare earth magnets here and boom, pulled right up. And that was capturing, see that little dog point goes down in there, and that was preventing that from coming out. So these come out, let me go ahead and pull those out. And I think that once we do that, this thing's gonna come on apart without too much trouble. So now let's go back up here and pull this thing apart using our screws that will just lift the plate off, and now you can see it's coming apart very easily. If something gets stuck, don't force it until it breaks. Stop and look. This stuff is not made to be that hard to come apart. So I think there we go. So that whole plate comes apart. Again, nice and clean on the inside. My, you got your screw plate in here. And so these little rack and pinions kind of run in here. And when you rotate this, so you can see here how this works. You know, you got that little kind of rack and pinion thing going on here. to turn the scroll. And now we will drop the scroll out. There it drops out. And you can see the scroll. So this is basically a scroll, and the backs of these engage into it, and as it turns, it moves this up and down. So we've got this apart. I think I'm gonna take it over to my parts washer, just get all the grease and stuff off of it, and we'll be ready to drop this into the tank with the evapo rust to try to clean up this outside of it and get it cleaned up like it needs to be as soon as we pull that other chuck out. All right, so we've been letting this four-jaw chuck soak for about 4 hours in the evapo rust, and we're gonna go ahead and pull it out now and see if we can get it cleaned up. Let's see. I'm just gonna take it over here to the sink where I can do some scrubbing on it and washing on it here. All right, so I just got a piece of Scotch-Brite here and scrubbing it a little bit. I wish that I had taken this over to the parts washer and got all the grease and stuff off of it first, like I just did that other chuck. I think that would have made this process go a little bit better, because there's definitely some grease on here that's, I think, kind of prevented the evaporust from getting down to the surface there. But you can see this is cleaning up real nice. We may have to let this soak a little bit more after we do this cleaning to get it completely clean and get all those stains off of it. So I'll let this four-jaw chuck soak now for about another 2.5 hours or so, and we're gonna pull it out and see what it looks like. See if we can, let me go ahead and turn this water on. See if we can go ahead and finish cleaning it up now. It looks a lot better. So, again, just some Scotch-Brite here. Hitting it on the sides a little bit. Oh yeah, this thing is beautiful. So, all right, I'm gonna just finish rinsing this thing off real good, get all this old evaporust off and dry it off, and we'll go over to the table and see about putting it back together. All right, and while we're working on the four jaw, I'm gonna put at least this part of the three jaw in here and let that be soaking. Probably just let that soak overnight. Come back in the morning and we'll pull it out and see what it looks like. I did take this one and clean it up in the parts washer ahead of time, so I'm thinking it's gonna probably be a little bit better than that last one. Wow, what a difference. This thing looks like a new chuck just about. I got just a little bit of a dark pitting over here on one side. I may try to sand some of that off on the lathe, just with some emery cloth once we get it on there. But all in all, it looks really good. I think first thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna kinda put some oil on it, and I'm using WD-40 here. And you know, I know a lot of people are not big fans of WD-40 as a oil for this kind of work, but the main reason I'm doing it is because I just washed this chuck. It's got a lot of moisture in it right now. And one thing that WD-40 is very good at, it's good at driving out moisture. So, you know, that's kind of what I'm trying to accomplish here or anything else right now, and to keep it from flash rusting again. I do want to make sure that we put a little bit of grease on these little worms in here. So I'm just using my grease gun And we're just going to put a little gob on each one of them. And that should spread out when I start cranking them down. These really shouldn't matter as far as which jaw goes on which one, but they are numbered. And I got a number one here. That's number four. Number two. Three. Of course, it's the last one. And right here, I got a number one. So I will put them back in like they come out. And we'll just bring it on down. So, all right, the four jaw is ready to go back on the lathe. Again, what a world of difference. Wow, looks like a different chuck than what we started with. And here she is, all mounted up on the lathe and ready to go here. Let me knock that out of gear. So, again, got a little bit of discoloration right in there. Not real happy with that, but it is what it is. It's not going to affect anything the way it works. So this is ready to go, and I've got a four jaw job coming up here pretty soon that we're going to be putting this to work on. So I just pulled the parts of the three jaw chuck out of the bath and cleaned them up a little bit, scrubbed them down, cleaned all the stuff off, and then put a little light coat oil on these as well. And just like the four jaw, these cleaned up really nice. This one here looks like a whole new chuck. So we're gonna go ahead and reassemble this one and get her put back together. So the first piece to go back in here is the scroll ring. Of course, we have the scroll on that side and the gear teeth on this side. But before we put it in there, I am gonna just kinda give it a little bit of grease. Can put it some lube in here that will help it along. So I'll tell you what, let's do. Let's put some down in the bottom here. There's two kind of wear surfaces in there. And I just want to get a little thin layer all through this thing. Take my fingers and kind of spread them out. Now I'm going to drop this piece back down in here. All right, that looks good. I'm just taking a little bit of that excess grease that I've got. I'm just putting a really light coat right around this little machine surface, because that's where these two parts are going to mate down together. And again, I just want to have enough in there and also in between here, just to help it go back together. And also, if there's any moisture, whatever gets in there, just get a little bit of protection. We're going to take the back plate now. I've already wiped this up real good, got it clean, and this will go back together. Now, I noticed when I took this apart, there was a little witness mark along the outside edge of this. In fact, I don't know if you can see it or not. Here it is on this piece. There's a matching mark around this. All right, here it is right here. It looks like they stamped maybe a number 8 on that. But we want to make sure those are lined up. There and there. So that'll kind of help me line them up. Just like so. And then I will take my three screws here, and we can just basically tighten this right down into place. Now we want to kind of go around these and put a little bit of pressure on each one of them and kind of bring it down evenly. So I'm just going to kind of go around this. I don't know, I'm going to give it about a quarter of a turn on each one. And again, that should bring it down kind of even around all sides. And I'm getting them all fairly snug here. So I think I'm just gonna take it. I'm not gonna try to over torque these. They were a little bit too tight before, but I am just gonna kind of take my hand and just tap them. I think that'll be enough torque to hold these down and hopefully if I ever have to take it back apart, it won't be as much trouble as it was this last time. All right, so now we have to put our little teeth in here, the gear that drives that plate and the chuck goes into. I'm just gonna kind of squirt a little light coat of oil in there just to give it some lubrication. These will slide in place. And this little screw going here. I tell you what, I think I'm gonna go over to the wire wheel and just clean those up. They look a little, look like they got a little trash in them. So let me do that, I'll be right back. All right, again, that goes down and that captures that little jaw in there so it can't come out. So we'll just screw it all the way in. Very good. Now, yeah, that turns the scroll just fine. Let's get the other ones put in. So we're ready to go ahead now and put our jaws back in here. And I'm just gonna kind of look around here, and I don't know if you can see that or not. Let's see. All right, so look right here. You see in this slot, see that little piece coming around there? That's the first tooth. This one is marked 1, 2, 3, and we want to put these in order. My little parts here are also stamped. This one is 1, so this one goes in here. So I'm going to pull that first thread back. We're going to slide this in. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put just a little bit of oil in here. We'll slide this one in. And it has caught. I'm going to watch back in number 2 until that tooth comes around. And boom, right there. I back up just a little bit. I find jaw number 2. It's very important that these go in the right order, because those the gears in the back here are timed so that they'll come in properly. So now we come around here and I'm looking for it to start here. All right, I'm gonna back up past that. Put just a little oil in there. Whoops, wrong way. That way. And now they should all come in, and I'm gonna bring it all the way down and close it up, make sure I've got them timed correctly. And you will know that when they all come in here together. And it looks like they are. I'm watching this little edge is hitting. They're all kind of hitting this ring at the same time, which is what we want. I'm gonna go ahead and bring them in just a little bit more. And we can, got a little gob of grease in there, I'll pull that out. Now we can go ahead and put our jaws back on. The jaws back on, these are numbered as well. I don't really know that these really matter that much. They were probably all ground originally on this particular one, so, you know, it's probably best to put them back together like they come apart. I'm just gonna put a little bit of oil in there. And there's 2 length screws. There's a long one and a short one. The long one goes in the front. The short one goes in the back. And we'll just put them on down. So there we go. One more chuck down here. And still got my 6th jaw to do. My 6th jaw, I believe, is pretty much identical to this one. It just has the extra 3 pieces put in there. I'm gonna go ahead and bring it over here. We'll take it apart, check it out, and get the process going on it as well. Well, my first thought, and without looking at this chuck too terribly close, is I thought it was the same as the 3 jaw, but now that I got it up here, I realize this is a totally different design. It's still a scroll chuck, but anyway, these don't have the front jaws that come off like the other one. This is only for gripping on inside are on the outside here, but on these, you only drip them on the inside. You can't flip them over, not with these. And it's a different, so just a whole different design. I'm not even sure if it's made by the same company as the other ones. So anyway, this one is probably the worst of them as far as current condition, just being dirty, greasy, grimy, whatever. But I don't think it has really seen a whole lot of use either. We'll know more about it once we get a chance to take it apart and clean it up. So let's see what we can do. First thing I need to do is find a key to fit this, and we'll see if we can go ahead and spin all these out. I got the pieces from the six jaw out of the evaporust now. They've been through the parts washer. They've been cleaned up with evaporust, so, and have a light coat of oil on them. So, and we're ready to put them back together. So looking at this particular chuck and having gone through and cleaned it up and everything, I can tell just from looking at it, this particular chuck has seen a considerable amount of use in it compared to the other two chucks. The other two chucks look practically brand new. This one here, it does have some wear in it. Don't get me wrong, it's still in good shape. It's not gonna be a problem, but it's by no means a new kid on the block. So anyway, we're gonna go ahead and start putting it back together, and I'll try to point out some of these wear areas as we go. First thing I'm gonna do is, like before, we're gonna just put a little bit of grease in here. So here's the scroll ring. The scroll itself looks like it's in pretty good shape. The teeth on the back where the little gear comes in, you can tell they're a little bit worn right here on the ends, but you get down in here and it's all right. So I don't think it's a big problem. But we'll go ahead and drop that down. The scroll goes to the back. All right, that feels good. Now, this little piece here, this is the gear that goes in here and actually turns the ring around in there. And this, on the other hand, has got a significant amount of wear in it. It's, I'd say about half the tooth is gone, but it's, I mean, it's still usable like it is, so we're gonna go with it. Let me put a little bit of grease down here as well. I'm gonna drop half of that ring down in there. That captures this so that it doesn't allow it to pull out. I'm gonna go ahead and put my other retaining ring in this one, and the grease is gonna kind of hopefully hold it in place. And we're gonna flip this over. Before I do that, I'm gonna just kind of put a little lightweight machine oil in here, just in between these two pieces. So I remember seeing this now. There's a little tab back here in the back. There's a little piece on the end, and that's got to fit up in there. So it's got to come in on this back piece, or this back piece has got to come on down on the bottom. There it goes. All right, I got my socket cap screws all just kind of started by hand. I'm just going to zip these down with the little DeWalt here. These don't need to be just torqued down like crazy, and I'm just doing that part there to kind of speed things along, but I'm going to torque these down by hand. I just feel like I get a better idea of what they're on here rather than trying to really ratchet down that thing. One thing I'll notice on the back here when I was putting it together that there was, I don't really see a name on it anywhere. There's some numbers and what have you. There's a 5127, looks like maybe a part number. But on the back, there was a 1074 on there, and I believe that was probably a date that it was made. Would have been in 1974. So anyway, that's my guess. So now we need to, like before, put our jaws in. I've got these laid out over here in order, 1 through 6. This one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I've got my scroll here, so I'm gonna do just like before. I'm gonna come around and I'm gonna, let's see, I believe it's gonna go this way. I'm gonna look for my first one to kind of engage. See, there's my first one just came through there. So we will take number one and we'll catch that one. And I'm gonna look around here till it gets over here. We'll catch number two. All right, so here go the set screws on the side. These, I'll probably have to adjust the first time I use this chuck to kind of get it like it needs to be lined up properly. But this is actually a very nice feature to have on a truck. Chuck is this, where you have this four jaw flexibility to fine tune a three jaw or six jaw like this together. So anyway, I'm glad to see that on there. And this chuck is all done. So there we go. Wow, what a difference. What a difference that chuck looks. I can't say it looks brand new because you can tell it's got some dings in it and some scratches and whatever from use over the years, but wow, compared to what we started with, amazing what a little clean job will do and a little bit of rust removal. Well, there you go, guys. Chuck restoration, I guess you'd call it. Just cleaning up some old chucks here. So here's my three jaw, my six jaw. The four jaw is on the lathe. I've actually got it about halfway set up to do a job over there that you guys will be seeing in a video real soon. But real excited to get these. You know, again, wow, what a difference this makes. And I'm excited to have not only these chucks cleaned up and really usable now, but also just to have a nice selection of chucks that came with that LeBlond lathe. Again, we came with a four jaw chuck, a three jaw chuck, a six jaw chuck. It came with a collet chuck, a 2J size collet chuck with a nice selection of collets. Came with a face plate and a dog plate. So pretty well equipped on the LeBlond, thank goodness. Next big question is to get these on the machine and really kind of see how true they're running and so forth. Again, the four jaw and the three jaw, these are both made by Rom. They're German made chucks, and both of these are in excellent condition, at least from what I can tell just looking at them. Very low signs of wear. I suspect that the gentleman that owned this machine before me may have purchased these two chucks new. The six jaw, it's an older chuck. It's got a good bit of wear in it. But overall, it looks like it's still in pretty good shape. I've worked and made and used chucks that are a lot more worn than this one. So anyway, we'll see. Again, time will tell once we get it on the machine and try it out. But I think we're going to be fine even with it. But anyway, with that, that'll be a wrap. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later.